Watching AUS men's volleyball featuring your Dalhousie Tigers. Today the Tigers host the number one team in the country, the Laval Rouge Or. And this was kind of the highlight matchup of the day, the Tigers and the Rouge Or. And of course today, earlier on, the Tigers were supposed to have a tune-up against the Verde Or from Sherbrooke. But I'm joined by Coach Damian Patterson and Coach that tune-up against Sherbrooke turned out to be a debacle, really, for the Tigers.
Yeah, it's like we talked all through the broadcast. They just, you know, never seemed to, I guess if you want to use a lack of a better word, synergy for the team. And they just seemed to be a step behind the whole time, made a lot of errors in the first and second set. That just dug themselves a hole, and they never could really get back out of it.
So a Tigers team that comes in here, they've dropped out of the national rankings. These are kind of uncharted territory we're getting in here with this Tigers team. They recently were released from the national rankings. They have now lost four matches on the year. They had that very upsetting loss to Sherbrooke just 6 hours ago. But good news on the horizon, Max Burt in the lineup tonight.
Yeah, as we know, Max was on a hiatus there with an injury for quite a long time, and that obviously affected the Tigers. They started him last night. They were successful last night. Wanted to rest him because it's his first weekend back this afternoon, but he'll be fired up and ready to go, I'm sure, tonight, like the rest of the team will be as well.
And, of course, the big if there's one shining spot tonight or today for the Tigers, it was Graham Higgins from Victoria. He was absolutely stellar tonight.
He did light it up, and like we said, we always look at those kill stats because that's the, you know, those are the, that's the glory of volleyball, the big hit, especially on the men's side. But when you look down the stat line and looked at the number of digs that he made, you know, the number of touches he got on blocks, he was all over the court. And you know, if he comes out firing on all cylinders, and Sander and Max Burt, it could be an exciting match here tonight.
And you got to figure, Sander Ratsup, as we mentioned during the Sherbrooke game, seemed like he was playing with a little bit more pressure on his shoulders. You got to figure with Max Burt coming back in here today that Sander might relax a little bit.
Yeah, I think he will. I think he'll settle in. You know, I don't think in men's volleyball you can be too over-motivated or too excited. Again, we talked about, you know, coming together, celebrating every point, and coming together when times are struggling. And Sander Rapsot isn't the loudest person on the floor, but he likes to lead by example, and I think we'll see a better game from him tonight.
And, Coach, you got to figure that this Laval team, we haven't seen them. They beat the Tigers once already this year. You got to figure this Laval team is pretty good. With all those powerhouse teams west of Ontario, Laval is ranked number one. You got to figure this is a pretty good Laval team.
Well, you're, you know, it's, as they say, it's no, so what I'm looking for, it's no, there's obviously a reason why they're number one in the country, and we'll see that here tonight, and everyone who's watching live at home or in front of their computers will, are in for a treat, I think.
Well, there's probably a lot of friends tuning in across the country to watch this broadcast. A lot of our friends out west. Again, all those powerhouse teams west of Ontario, all nationally ranked. Even Thompson Rivers with a 3-7 record, nationally ranked. So they will be tuning in here to check out this Laval team. But first, we will pause for O Canada. O'Canada is in the books. And here we go. It's the number one Rouge Or versus the AUS champion, Dalhousie Tigers, right here on SSNCanada.ca. Thanks for joining us coast to coast. Reminder, your email is tigerswebcast@gmail.com. Tigerswebcast@gmail.com. And coach, we were talking about the Sherbrooke team that came in here and kicked some butt today. One of the great things you can always expect from teams from Quebec is that high level of spirit and intensity.
That's right, yeah, and I think we'll see that right out of the gate with Laval. You can see them already getting ready, arms around, yelling. They are fired up. You know, as we said, that wonderful spirit by the Quebec teams. You know, it's fun to watch.
Well, here are your announcement of the Tigers. Again, the Tigers, a tough loss today. But from Gander, Newfoundland, here is Max Burt. Our first call of Max Burt all season long here at the Dalplex. Good to have him back.
And music to the Tigers' ears, too.
How about there to the Burts and Gander. Sander Ratsip struggled a bit today. Kind of one for one with Sander today. For every great play, he had a bad play.
Yeah, that's right. He couldn't find his rhythm, and again, we talked about passing. They struggled passing, so it was tough for Rulon to get those balls to the outside, and I think that might have had something to do a little bit with it.
Dan Bremner from Calgary, Alberta. Kind of struggled today getting going. We got curious fans here. We are on SSNCanada.ca. Great crowd tonight at the Dalplex. Travis McLean. Hello there to the coach, Kerry McLean.
I spoke to Travis after this afternoon's game, and obviously they were very, very disappointed in what they had to give this afternoon, and he's already promised for a different showing here tonight. So
a guarantee from Travis McLean?
Not a guarantee, no. Just a better showing. A guarantee that they will play better. But he didn't necessarily put a guarantee there on the scoreboard. So,
well, they are in tough against the number one team in the country, the Rouge Or. You know, we're so used to the number one football team coming to Halifax to play St. Mary's. But tonight it's the number one volleyball team. And there's not much better than the number one team in the country coming to your place.
No, absolutely. And it just, you know, goes to show you the athletic programs that Laval keeps turning out. And in all sports, really, it's a great school.
Well, the Tigers are going to get started. It's Robert Brownells, Angus Rulon. The coach, talking to him earlier, of course, does a lot of strength and conditioning with Angus. And he will get it started here for the Tigers. Miss hit by Laval, and easy pickings over there for Graham Higgins. That's a good start.
That's a great start.
So reception problems early for Laval. That is Boudreau. And a big block right away, coach. Max Burt.
Yeah, he figures right in right away. You know, some of the problems with the blocking this afternoon was timing, and you really need your partner to time on that. So if you're used to having Big Max beside you, it's a little different when you have someone else beside you.
That is Boudreau. And a miss hit by the Tigers. Mondu. Get started for Laval. So Laval on the board. And it is Frederic Mondu. Back to serve now for the Rouge Or. Travis McLean, Rulon, and Graham Higgins. A little change of pace for Higgins. And that is Debier. And a free ball here for Laval. They'll go to work in system. On the far side, big block by Burt and Bremner.
It looked like that was all Bremner there. Burt was a little late, and that was a one-on-one, and he just shut him down.
And Bremner with a show of emotion, coach. And he was a little flat in the first game.
Yeah, we definitely didn't see that emotion this afternoon.
So here is Calgary's Dan Bremner. And a miss hit for Laval. And a free ball for the Tigers to go to work here. Max Burt, big block in the middle by Laval. Bebo Pinard. And Bebo Pinard, after that big block on Max Burt, will go back to serve. 3-2 in the early going for the Tigers. Travis McLean. And Sander. As we always say, Coach, when Sander's in system and gets a good set, it's pretty much lights out.
Yeah, again, it wasn't this afternoon, but in most times it is. And, you know, it just seemed collectively they had a bad game. And teams will do that. And, I mean, they're looking like the Tigers we've seen before. But Max Burt just stepped over the line there on his serve. So.
Well, some rust maybe for Max Burt right there.
I think so. I think it'll be shaken off pretty quickly, though.
Max Burt from Gander, Newfoundland, home of the Gander International Airport. Messed up my bags over the Christmas holidays, but we will not hold that against the Burt family. 5-3. Gorgeous town in Gander, right in the middle of the valley there in Newfoundland. And Graham Higgins, 5-3 lead for the Tigers. And that is Debian. And again, Coach, you know, the number one team in the country here, Laval, but like Sherbrooke, not physically imposing to look at. Kind of a guys are all 6'4 and shorter.
Yeah, again, we talked in both webcasts about, you know, passing and you know, historically the Quebec teams have always been very good at passing, very good at defense. Of course, you need the hitting and the big blocks. But again, it starts with passing, and they are known nationally for passing the ball well.
Well, there you see it, Coach. Good call. That is Girard, a quick 51.
And again, you can't run a 51 unless you get a good pass, right? So.
And nobody over 6'6 on this Laval team. Quick and speedy, athletic. And as Coach said, outstanding passing. Here on the West Coast, probably about 4 o'clock in the afternoon. And I got to believe some of those coaches are checking in on this Laval team.
Yeah, I think teams are used to the Tigers being in the CIS championships. And, you know, depending on the rankings, if Laval stays number one and Dallas stays where they are out of the rankings, they could see each other in the first rounds of the CIS championships. So.
So 7-6 for the Tigers here in their early stages of the first set. And this is Debian. Big, powerful serve. Goes wide on the near side. Point to the Tigers, our first time out. So, Coach, our friends out, speaking of beautiful Gander, Newfoundland, Max Burt, of course, there. My wife's from Grand Falls. Gorgeous country, Newfoundland. And I have apologies to extend to our friends in Newfoundland. I kind of taken out of context today with my comments about the Memorial Volleyball Program. What I meant to say was that the program has really hit hard times in terms of wins and losses, but it was came across as being maybe that the program is in trouble of being falling out of competition altogether. So my sincere apologies to our good friends there in Newfoundland. I never meant to say that the team was in trouble of disbanding, but just that they were really struggling to win games nowadays.
Yeah, that's right, and I think we both kind of spoke to how good volleyball is looking now on the island, and you know, with that high school team winning the Pepsi Challenge, and you know, I talked about the importance of having you know, the program to stay on the island, and by no means I think the program, as you said, is in trouble disbanding and coming out of league. It really was to talk about the wins and losses columns, and my sincere apologies too to our friends on the island. I know Fitton out there, the Beach Provincial team coach, may be listening, and he and I are good friends. So, Fitton, my personal apologies to you as well.
And my sincere apologies as well. And again, hopefully we can move on and not speak of this again. But my sincere apologies to the friends of Newfoundland, and look forward to seeing the Seahawks here against the Tigers coming up later this term.
For sure, and on that, you know, we talk mostly about the men's side, but the women's team is really showing some progress. So,
and Big Max Bird, speaking of Newfoundland, on cue with a big hit, and a 9-7 for the Tigers. And Dan Bremner back on the service. Boudreaux, and too much. De Grand Prix. So Laval Rougeor from beautiful Quebec City. Hello out there to all you friends in Quebec City. Remember, your email is tigerswebcast@gmail.com. There's Ratsup. Laval got a piece and a hustling. Boudreaux. Nicely done.
That was a great dig.
Scrappy Tigers here have turned away a couple of great hits by Laval, and now make do.
This seems more like the Tiger team that I'm used to watching.
The Tigers fend off a couple of great Laval hits and get a point. And they're the service line now. Max Burt. Great to have Max back on the floor for the Tigers. And there's Vince Dock, the fifth-year senior.
Said not this time. Max Bird back to serve.
This Tigers team loaded with fifth-year seniors. Ratsup, Burt, Vince Dock. It is now or never for this incredible group of seniors. And crafty there is the Grand Prix.
That's always a struggle as an athlete when you're injured and you can't get in there to help out your team. But when you're in your fifth year and all you want to do is, you know, spend your last year on the floor and help out your team as much as you can. Shows the character of Max Burt, ready just to come in here and contribute back to the team. So.
Graham Higgins, blocked by Laval. Higgins recovers, and now Sander on the other side. Laval's got this one under control. Deprande comes up short. And 12-9 for the Tigers. So some separation now on the national champs.
Back to serve for the Tigers.
And this is Victoria's. We're coast to coast tonight, Coach. Gander, Newfoundland, Victoria, BC. That is Higgins from Victoria.
Well, and I have a lot of high school athletes that tell me, you know, can I make a university team? And my advice is always, you have to remember that coaches are recruiting not just from all over Canada, but now it's almost all over the world, where you see, you know, some players, from Japan playing in the CIS. We had Nick Rockmacher from Germany here for years. So it really is becoming international recruiting. And so when a local athlete says, you know, do I have a chance of making it? If they're a good athlete and work really hard, I think anyone has a chance. But you got to be aware that the recruiting pool is bigger than just the Maritimes. So.
Well, Sander from London, Ontario. That one sails on Sander. Of course, he was the big recruit from London.
You know,
Notice it stole him from the Ontario area.
Yeah, I'm glad to see Sander ripping at the ball. He kind of changed his serve, as we saw in the match this afternoon. Kind of took some off. I'm hoping he's going to keep swinging, and his serve will come to him for sure tonight.
Ruland, Laval scrambling. Debier, and that's off the Tigers. So we're pretty much even here at the middle stages, 13-12 for the Tigers in our first set. Late start today, friends. Thanks for hanging with us. The Montreal Memorial game went a little bit late. Montreal, a big five-set victory over Memorial. That one handled by Higgins. And now a free ball for Laval. They will go to work. From the back row, that is Deb Grand Prix. I saw some of the Montreal Caravan walking around the city today after we finished up with our 90-minute match against Sherbrooke. And they seem like they were having a great time in the city.
Well, we all know that's what the reputation of Halifax is. We're well known for hosting events. The Canada Games are here just a few short weeks away. You know, in late August, early September, we're going to see the 2011 FIVB World Championships of Beach Volleyball here.
That'll be good times, Coach, right down on the waterfront and around Labor Day.
That's right.
Yep. Debian, blocked by Max Burke. And from the back row to Grand Prix, and this time wide. So as we approach our second timeout, Binstock here on the service line in a 15-13 lead for Dalhousie. Nice serve here by Binstock. Debiet blocked out of bounds by the Tigers.
The Tigers getting a hand on everything. Coming over the net, like we talked about this afternoon, they really need to reach across the net, press, seal, and they seem to be just a little early, and again, they're coming down when they almost should be going up, so.
And that one sails on Debiet. So 16-14 for our second technical timeout, and Coach, talking about, you know, the Halifax and the hosting of events and volleyball, and again, these championships coming up in late August on the beautiful Halifax waterfront. That is going to be good times.
It's going to be a blast. What I really like, what Sport Entertainment Atlantic has done, is really made it accessible for everyone. For $5, you can get a general admission ticket and walk around, check out any of the games. I think it's $65 for a tournament pass. Don't quote me. I think you have to go on, I think it's seatlantic.ca, I believe, is the website for more information. But we're excited because our men's junior team last year won the world championships in Turkey. That was the first time in the 10-year history of the event that we were even on the podium, let alone getting a gold. And half of that team, Garrett May, will be back. And he's actually being coached by Marquise, who won a bronze medal in 96. And Volleyball Nova Scotia has a great relationship with Marquise, who's been out here a couple of times to do some clinics and work with our athletes, and we continue to work with Mark. So, you know, there's a great camaraderie, and the community of volleyball in Canada is strong and well.
So those are the, what is the exact dates before Labor Day?
So it's I can't remember the exact dates. Again, you can check out the website, but it's the Tuesday leading up to Labor Day,
Labor Day. So check for that here in the Halifax area. That is going to be good times. Nothing like summer, late summer in Halifax, and that event will just make it that much better. All the kids will be back in town for school.
Exactly.
Yep. That's when the cruise ship season really takes off. And there's a point for Laval. Just east through the block. JBM. 16-15. Coach Damian Patterson, my name is Bill McLean. Hardeep is on the camera. And Jonathan is our producer. Max Burt. Coach, you feel like we've been missing something. And it's been those big 51s with Max Burt.
That's right. And we talked, and again, he was able to hit that because of the passing. The passing is solid. This game, as we talked about, it wasn't this afternoon. You can't run a 51 unless you have passing. So
that one is out. Point to the Tigers.
I think. I was just going to say. I think Laval should call a timeout now. And
there we go. 18-15 here for the Tigers. So after what was really. Again, an uncharted disappointment for the Tigers today against Sherbrooke, something we haven't seen here in a long time, that straight sweep loss to Sherbrooke. Tigers have responded very well here so far.
Yeah, and again, we said it at the end of the game, they needed to put that game behind them. They had a bad game. That's what you chalk it up to. I'm sure that's what Coach Oda was saying. He obviously wasn't happy. I'm sure he shared that with his players, and and then the next message was, we need to get ready for tonight. So you move on from a game like that. They've certainly come ready to play. And again, it obviously does help having Max Burt back in the lineup.
You know, Tigers webcast
Sorry, no, I was just going to say, you know, when you look at the CIS website and see, you know, that they lost to Laval three straight on October 30th, you need to take that into context and see that both Sander Retzup and Max Burt were out of the lineup. So Laval's getting a bit of a different look. The Dal team looks a little different than they did in October. So.
Well, a service error by Dan Bremner, and this might open the door here for Laval. Brian Duquette in for Dan Bremner. And Etienne Gauthier in here for Laval. So Gauthier in here to serve. Third-year player. 16-18, trail the Rougeor. Hustling Rulin and Sander. Blocked by Laval. And Desprandes blocked by Max Burt. And handling on Laval.
Max Burt serving. Substitution in the match. Mathieu Fignon.
Mathieu Fignon.
Replacing Carl de Grandpré.
In here for Laval. And Max Burt to serve for the Tigers. And we got timeout for Laval, so. Laval coach, Laval coach, yeah, not happy with what's going on here. He wants to kind of get the guys sorted around here for maybe a late charge.
Yeah, again, I think the same thing's happening to Laval that happened to the Tigers. You know, they're making errors, hitting errors, serving errors. Now, with that said, we've seen some big blocks and some big hits from Max Burt. Graham Higgins is continuing his stride from this afternoon. So, you know, give the Tigers full credit. They're pushing Laval here, and you're right. Pascal is not happy right now with his team.
Well, Coach, I'm a master of self-promotion, and if you go to the front page there on SSNCanada.ca, you can see my blog and in my five games of the year, second term in Halifax. This is my number five pick, and as Coach Kerry McClain gave me a hard time, I had it, you know, maybe backwards. But I had it at number five because the Tigers weren't quite themselves coming into this. But still, easily one of the top five matches to see in the city this year in all across all sports. And we got a pretty good crowd here tonight.
Yeah, it's a great crowd. I driving in here, I was passing the Oval, and the Oval was pretty busy, so I was worried that we might lose some fans to the Oval. It's been pretty popular here in the city, but no, it's a great crowd. And you know what? One of the things I always love about the program here at Dal is the history and the support from the alumni. You know, you look down to our right and you see players that I played against, we won't say back in what year, but players like Eric Villeneuve, Brian Warwick. To our left, we have Al Scott, the former coach before Dan Oda. Dan Oda was his assistant coach and then took over for Al once he became the athletic director. And Al's now the executive director for Volleyball Nova Scotia, which we are fortunate to have.
Higgins back to work for the Tigers. He has had himself a Saturday. Outstanding play today by Higgins. Had about 14 kills for the Tigers. And Angus Campbell, the Halifax product, getting in here.
Again, they're putting Angus in not as a sort of a setter sub, but more of a large block to put up there on the other side. And let's see if it works.
That one gets by Campbell. Ratsam. And handled there by McLean. Nicely done. This is Ratsam. And too much there for Laval.
What a great rally. You know, that was tough for Angus Campbell. Aaron Bernstock was late on that block, so he was the only one out there. But he actually forced the player to hit to one of the defensemen. And we always think, you know, you're not doing your job if you don't get a hand on the block. But if you can force a player to hit somewhere, you're doing your job just as well. So.
Graham Higgins back on the service line. 21-18 for the Tigers in our first set. Confusion for Laval. And a big hit that goes wide, actually off a Tiger. Actually in. I thought it was wide, but I guess it fills in. So, Carl de Grand Pre. And he will go back to the service line. The number one team in the country, Laval Rouge Or. Graham Higgins. Rulin, Ratsup. Too much for Laval.
He's hitting high, he's hitting hard.
And Sanders got his groove on here so far.
Yeah, the entire Tigers team does it. And again, passing is great, setting's great, hitting's great, blocking's better. A much different team than we saw this afternoon.
Well, this is Ratsup back to the service line now. 22-19 for Dalhousie. We'll change of pace. Boudreaux, and no problem for Laval.
Again, I'd like to see Sander Ratsup really rip that ball. That's, you know, that's what he's known for, is one of his good hard serve. And it, you know, strategically, he may want to take some off there, but they may want to change that strategy because
22-20 for the Tigers. This is Girard. Ratsup. Bremner. Boudreaux. And Mondu. Bremner again. Big block by Laval, but Higgins was there. Bremner blocked again. That is Debien. This time it's Sander. Nicely done by Boudreaux. Bit of a miss hit there for Mondu. And that one sails on Sander. And how about a little bit of grit there from the champions, or from the number one team?
Yeah.
Hustle there.
This is really fun to watch. If you're in the stands or you're in front of your computer right now, you're getting treated to some very fun and very high caliber volleyball. You know, I think that's a good call by Dan. Settle down the team. Let's try to close this game out. You know, we talk about the tradition and the alumni. We talked about the alumni are here today, but, you know, we had a text or an email from Eric Montgomery this afternoon. I spoke to Jeff Daniels on Facebook this afternoon. He's watching tonight, so hi to Jeff Daniels. He's in the Valley tonight, so.
Well, that last point, 22-21 now, and that was kind of a decisive point at this point in the set. The Tigers really came on to a couple of hits there, but Justine Boudreaux really a couple of nice hits or a couple of nice bumps, and that was some pretty scrappy play by the number one team in the country, Laval.
Yeah, and again, that's the reputations of the Quebec teams. They're always scrappy. They're always great on defense. You know, and that, it's such a cliche, but in most sports, defense wins championships, right? So.
22-21. And this is Girard. Ratsup once again for the Tigers. From the back row, Max Burt.
Oh my God.
A big hit from Max. And 23-21 now.
Looks like they're calling Max Burt stepping over the attack line. When you're hitting from the back row, for those kids out there, you can't step over that that red line there, three quarters of the way towards the net, and he may have just stepped on it or gotten a full foot over, but anyways, he was called, and that's a big call at now 22-all.
And a big block by Laval, so the tide is turning here. The scrappy point, the foot violation by Burt, and now a big block by Laval, and all of a sudden, Laval has control in this first set.
By the Tigers.
23-22 for Le Rouge Or. And that's the kind of a window that Laval needs, you know, like Max with the step on the line, and next thing you know, here we go, 23-22.
That's right, yeah. You know, if I'm the timeout right now as the Tigers, I'd be talking to Rulin and saying, you know what, let's set Max Burt again in the exact same spot, and let's see him put it away again. You know, a lot of I spoke about this afternoon. Sometimes setters will get away from a hitter that's made one mistake and go to the other hitters. I think, especially when you have a national caliber player, I think you want the ball to go back to him at especially at 22-23. So I would look for the ball to go to either Sander here or back to Max Burt.
Well, here we go. Critical point right now. 23-22. And Michael Girard to serve for Laval. And Rougier Orr trying to hold off the Tigers here. Grats up again. Rulin. And Dan Bremner.
We didn't see that this afternoon from Bremner. That's why I thought for sure they would go to Rapsat or Burt. And I guess Laval did too, because they left him wide open.
So Dan Bremner, his first big point, and now Binstock. Rubin. And that is it for Debian.
It's a great hit.
Well, Coach Frederick Debian will go back to serve, and the Le Rouge Or 1 point away from a first set victory.
Yeah, again, if you're Laval, I think you key on Max Burt in the front here in the middle.
It's Max. Debian's got it. Roulin, and from the back row, and a big block for the Tigers on Dicker or Pryor.
That's a huge point in this point of the match. Now at 24-24.
So we'll go to extra points. 24-24. In our first set, it's been a doozy. Roulin. And big athletic Mondu. Mondu very much like Wallet in our first match.
Yep.
Not tall, but
nope.
He can really
You're right.
Up.
They're built the same. They get off the ground just the same.
Well, speaking of Mondu, here he is back on the service line. That is Travis. Graham Higgins. Yeah, here we go. 25-25 now.
That was a great change-up shot. The last time he came in and he hit the ball as hard as he could, you could just see all the Laval team brace for a big hit, and that stopped him, and he just rolled it into the middle.
So hammer here to the Tigers. This is Bremner. A little punch play here by Lapointe.
Tigers got to take advantage here.
Graham Higgins. Lapointe again. From the back row. Debian, that might have gone out, but... played by Bremner, and Sander gets blocked by Boudreau. Tell you what, you got your center up there blocking Sander Ratsip. That's not bad. Stealing a hard-fought point. At 26-25. Now Laval has the hammer. Sander again. Touched by Laval. Boudreau. Burt was there for the block. Debian. Off of Max Burt. And there's your first point. We got some Laval fans over here to our left. Very happy. So the Rougier Or have some fans in the house. Probably made the bus trip down from Quebec City. And a first set victory for Rougier Or, 27-25. We got a feeling, Coach, this is maybe going to go four or five sets here. The Tigers seem pretty fired up.
I hope so. I mean, you get your money's worth when you have a match going to four or five between two high-caliber teams like this. Whether, you know, the Tigers are out of the rankings right now, top 10. You know, they have been a top 10 team for many, many years. You know, they were up until this week. You know, and again, they were there without Max Burt. Now they have him back, so... you know, it's a different look, a different team. You know, the first set, I think the turning point there when it was so close was that Max Burt, you know, back row call, and that just seemed to turn the tide a little bit. And when you're trading points for points in this rally point scoring, a call like that, you know, can affect the game. You tell your players, you know, don't worry about it, move on. But again, it's easier said than done.
Well, there was a three-point stretch there when the Tigers were up, I think, 21-19. And they had Laval made that scrappy play to kind of hold off the Tigers. And then Max Burt had the step on the line. And then Laval had the big block. And all of a sudden, 3 points are to Laval. And that dynamic of the match totally changes.
That's right.
And that seemed kind of like that pivotal point for sure.
That's right. I mean, we're just seeing a different Tigers team from what we saw this afternoon. Just having Scott deliver us the stats here. Thanks, Scott. You know, So we're going. No, I was just going to say, looking at the stats, you can see that the Tigers are able to spread the ball a little more than they were this afternoon because of the great passing that they're getting. You know, in the middle already, you know, they've set the middle five times and they've set the outside five times. Kills have come from there. And the attempts are pretty close. They're pretty even. When you're running an offense like that, it gives the other team lots to think about. Where's the ball going? Where am I going to block? You know, and we saw that a little bit from Laval when the Tigers came out of a timeout. After, you know, back Max Burt stepped on the line, I said, look to them to go to Sander or go to Max Burt. But then again, they sent it out to Bremner. They were giving them so many different looks, and I think that's why they're seeing some success. Now, they didn't win that first set, but they're right there. And when it's back and forth, as they say, it's anybody's game.
Well, TigersWebcast@gmail.com is your email. TigersWebcast@gmail.com. Hope to hear from you tonight. Wherever you are across this great country, watching the Tigers and La Rouge et Or.
You know, the bigger attacker for the first game at Laval is Frederick Debien. 8 kills and 16 attempts. You know, he's one of the higher percentages up there for both teams. The Tigers will have to be cognizant of that and key on him a little bit more, I think.
So here we go. Your second set from the Dalplex. Tigers are in the black uniforms on the left-hand side and the Rouge et Or on the right-hand side with the red.
For the second set.
And the Rouge et Or hold off the Tigers in the first set and now have a one set to nothing victory, and Max Burt getting going here.
He's just so fun to watch. He reminds me of another middle that was on the national team. I believe Terry Martin was here and when Max first showed up to practice 5 years ago. Just his build and even the way he looks reminded me of Terry a lot. So.
Well, out of bounds this time. Max was over there with Sander. But point to Laval. And now 1-1 in early going. And the service line is Justin Boudreau. Roulette with Max. And another kill for Max Burt.
You know, and a good job for Ruland to force a ball like that when it's passed just on the attack line. That's a tough set for a setter, and he took a chance and obviously paid off. Doesn't hurt, obviously, that you're setting Max Burt, a national team player, but nevertheless.
Well, there is Max Burt from the service line, and Boudreau, and Debian, Bremner, Ruland, and Sander. Laval's got this one under control from the back row. Rulin's got to hurry. What a great play. Rulin and you. The hustle.
Yeah, we said at the top of the broadcast, one of the bright spots of this afternoon was Graham Higgins, but followed closely behind the hustle of Rulin. As I said, the Tigers had a rough passing game, but he was all over the floor getting the sets where they needed to go.
Coming up short there is Max Burt on that serve.
Looked like he also stepped over a line again. I think we don't see Rust blocking and hitting, but maybe on the serving he...
Well, Max Burt over here is going to walk over to the other court and kind of give his head a shake. Again, Coach, you got to expect some rust. He has sat out a lot of time. And a big hit from Laval with Frederic Mondeau. And, Coach, you remember last year, of course, Eric Montgomery as well. He was a fifth-year senior and a prominent member of this Tigers team who recovered from injury, and it took him a while to get back into the flow and kind of seeing the same thing right now with Max Burt.
Yeah,
flashes of brilliance, of course.
For sure, yeah. It's
intertwined with some rust.
Yeah, I don't think the rust will last very long. I think...
Daniel Yu. Graham Higgins. Debian blocked by the Tigers. And Debian again, and again. And that is touched. Net violation by Sander.
Net violation called against the Tigers.
And the official doesn't want to hear it. But Sander Ratza.
So for those people tuning in, you are actually allowed to touch parts of the net, and there's parts of the net you're not allowed to touch. So that's kind of what Santa Ratsat was arguing about. Again, the Tigers got to let those kinds of calls go. Focus on the next point.
Well, this is a vicious serve here from Carl Deprande. He can really wire it up. There's another one. McLean does well. And now Sander. And now Laval scrambling. And a free ball for Dalhousie. Started with Higgins. Rule it. And Higgins gets it back. To the Tigers. A great first touch by Travis McLean on that serve.
It was a great pass, but even to get that point there, the set selection for Angus Rulin, again, spreading out the offense. Again, you have you and Rapsat up there, and he, you know, sets it to the right side to put it away.
Debian going back to work for Laval.
That shot down the line scores.
So Debian and Degrandpre for the Laval Rougeaux can hit it. They some fierce hitters on this Laval team.
Yeah, Mondu as well. When you look at the stats, those are their three go-to guys.
6-4, and Sanders got a backtrack, takes a seat. And that is Mondu, coach, you just mentioned, with a big hit. And we get 7-4 now for Laval. Not sure what's going on over there on the far sideline.
I don't know either.
But we're back to action here. This is Girard. Confusion for the Tigers leads to a free ball for Laval. And a miss hit. Scrambling play now. Rulin, you. And now Laval insists on. And no mistake for Laval on that one. So clumsy play by both teams. And Laval gets it under control. And Graham Higgins has word for the official. I'm not sure what he might be talking about, Coach.
I'm not sure either.
Yeah. But anyways, 8-4 at our first time out for Laval. And so we're about 2 hours into Dalhousie volleyball today, and the Tigers have yet to win a set. And now trailing 8-4, this is not one of the more remembering days in Dalhousie volleyball history so far.
Yeah, no, I think and you know we've been here most of the day, but hopefully in the heads and the eyes of the Tigers, this evening is a new day, let's say, and you know they came out really strong in that first set, had a tough call against them to kind of turn the tides, you know. But what I'd like to see from the Tigers going forward in this game is they got to stop looking at the ref every time there's a call.
Right.
Santa Rapsat's kicked the ball. They've questioned both referees. Focus on what you need to do. Next point. And just, they have a job to do, and you need to take care of the job. And they did that very well in the first set. And so,
Coach, is this a problem with this Tigers team? Because it seems like every time we do a men's broadcast, we talk about the Tigers have to get over their referees and focus.
I don't think it's, I mean, if it continues, obviously it'll be a problem, and
right,
Coach Otto will address it. You know, it's, you know, there is protocol. The only person that's supposed to talk to the ref is the captain. You know, the coach can call the captain over to go talk to the ref, but the only person, to even question the ref should be the captain. So, I'm not sure who the floor captain is right now, but.
Well, there's a tough ball handling call on Angus Rulin. And now the Tigers on a poor first pass. And 10-4 for Laval. And the Tigers are really looking rattled right
now.
Coach is going to call a timeout. The Tigers really seem to be discombobulated almost right now.
Yeah, Coach Odom made a change in the passing lineup. He's taken McLean out of the passing rotation. I'm not sure why he's done that. They've hit Max Burt and then gone to a three-person serve receive, and I wonder if he won't go back to McLean passing. So I guess we'll see here.
Coach, we got a great email from
Fintan
Gaudet, your buddy there in Newfoundland. Yeah. Nothing taken out of context, but apology accepted. So we're good with one Newfoundlander at least. Thanks very much, Fintan.
Yeah. Well, I don't know many Newfoundlanders, but he's one of the better ones, I'm sure. You know, a lot of the success that they're seeing on that island, both provincially on the beach and I know with his high school teams, he puts an awful lot of work and an awful lot of time into the sport and has for years. Newfoundland's lucky to have him, and I'm lucky to have him as a friend.
So thanks for that, Emil Fitton. Hope you're enjoying the game. And there we go. There's one of your native sons, Max Burt, getting back to work for the Tigers. 10-5.
See if the Tigers can turn it around here.
Well, it is Sander on the service line. He needs the strings to gather some points to get this Tigers team. There's that serve we're used to from Sander. But Laval handles it, and no problem for the Rouge Or with Mondu.
Tigers a little late on that block. They were sailing outside sort of the antenna, and they just wiped it off the hands.
And Debian back to serve for Laval. Bremner on the far side over there. Big hit and a free ball for the Tigers with you. And again, Laval showing that scrappy play. Just keeping it in play. And Laval again with a block on you. And now Sander. And a big block by Laval. And look at Frederick Mondu. How fired up is he? Coach, that was up. That was a big point for Laval right there. That was very scrappy.
Yeah, again, they're going to fight to the end. And, you know, it's a game of momentum. And it's tough when you have a huge block like that and then you miss your serve. Again, the tide can turn so quickly here. And, you know, Yu's got a really good serve.
So 12-6, trail the Tigers. And here is Calgary's Danielle Yu. Debian, and that is off the ceiling here at Dalplex.
You can hear the Tigers coaching staff yell, wait. Tigers are really early on their block, and they just need that patience. Again, when you have that excitement and that adrenaline going through you, you want to get there and do your job, but just got to wait a little longer, and they'll see a little more success, I think.
Bit of a mistimed hit there with Max Burt. And now Bremner on the far side. Laval has this one under control. That is Greg Grandpre. He's a big hitter. And we got some big-time separation for Laval. 14-6 now.
Yeah, and it seems to be the Laval's game plan to set the left side, knowing that Angus Rulin is out there blocking. They've gone after him for the last three hits there, it looks like.
Bremner, controlled by Laval. And that is Debian from the back row. And a miss hit. And Coach, everything's rolling now for Laval. That should have been Dallas Point. But a big block right at the net. Finds the back corner.
Yep.
So even when they have a miss hit, they still recover for points.
That's what good teams do.
Mondu, he's on a roll now for Laval. Max Burt, confusion with Ruland. And confusion now for Laval leads to a chance for the Tigers. For the back row is Rats up. Finally, the Tigers break through.
Yeah, Sander won't let you block him twice, that's for sure.
15-7 for Laval, and this is Angus Ruland. Lapointe. Big Ron Frey. Nicely done here for Bremner. Lapointe's got that one under control. Well done by Sander Rassa. Graham Higgins. And we got a great point now. And it's to the Tigers! So maybe the best point of the day for the Tigers that we've seen. That was a great point.
Yeah, for sure. And Laval's arguing that there should have been a double contact. They had one let go on their side, too. So they're even, I'm sure. Peter Moore, our official tonight, will call a little tighter after that, but it's sort of a back and forth.
Big Grand Prix trying to go to work, and again, Santa Ratsup now doing it defensively for the Tigers. The free ball for Laval, and a 51 with no mistake for Laval by Bibeau Pinard. And, well, Coach, it was kind of a nice little run there by the Tigers, but as we approach our timeout now, 16-8, and Laval really in control.
Yeah, they are. I believe the Tigers can come back here, though. You have Max Bird in the front row now. You know, look for the ball going to him. You know, in the first set, they set him six times. Again, we know the stats in front of us from this side. I haven't been keeping track, but I think I've only seen two balls go to Max Bird in the front. Again, it goes back to passing. Again, they've gone with a different passing rotation. They've taken Travis McLean out of the passing rotation and put him in for defensive digging. Obviously, Coach Oda has his reasons for that. I thought McLean was passing fine at the beginning and in the first set. So, you know, there may be an injury there we don't know about. Who knows? But one quick change that Oda can do is change back to that service reception and see if they can have success here. So we'll see when they come back onto the floor if McLean's passing or not.
Well, Coach.
And here he comes. So.
Max Bird out there. Higgins. Four sets so far the Tigers have lost in succession. And now in dangerous territory of losing five sets in a row. Saturday, bloody Saturday so far for the Tigers. They have got to get to work here against this Quebec barrage. And now it's Laval. And 17-8 for Le Rougeor. And again, it is Bibeau Pinard. Rulant. Higgins, that one sails on Graham Higgins.
Now ball goes long.
18-8 now for Laval. These are strange times at the Dalplex for Tigers fans. That one comes up short.
18-9.
Here is Calgary's Dan Bremner, new to the Tigers this year. Played last year in the Alberta Colleges Conference. Big block by the Tigers with Burt and Higgins. And a miss hit for Laval. And 2 points in a row for Dalhousie. Tigers. Bremner serving again. 18-10 for the Tigers. Bremner comes up well short. A miss hit at Bremner.
I think you'll see him maybe get taken out here. And the first-year libero, Brian Duquette. Oh, and well, there you go. I think... Coach Oda wants to settle some things down, uses a substitution to kind of slow the momentum down of Laval and gets a goes back to the two-person receive service reception there.
So Duquette in here for Bremner. From the back row. That is off the Tigers and point to Laval.
That ball catches a piece of the block before sailing out. Justin
Boudreau, the setter for Laval. 20-10, lead the Rougeor in the second set. Already up a set. Rulin and Sandoretsa. Rougeor have this one under control. Big Ron Prey off of Travis McLean.
Tigers really need to take advantage of the rotation they're in now. You have both Max Bird and Sandoretsa up in the front row.
21-10 for Laval. Justine Boudreau. And a miss hit. But well done by Rulin. Here's the Max Bird. And we talked about it earlier, but the hustle of Angus Rulin on some of these plays really is quite phenomenal.
Yeah, you know, he worked so hard to get to where he is, and it's so good to see him on the floor. I know that he has some family out there watching tonight, so... They should be proud of the performance that he had this afternoon and continuing tonight.
But Laval has an answer again, and now the Tigers really are in desperate trouble here. 22-11 in the second set. And Dick Ronfray with that big serve gets a bit of a net. And there is Angus with Sander. And Laval make something work out of this. Block there by you. In the back row is De Grand Pre. And it's Sales. Well, Dan Bremner, or Graham Higgins from Victoria, is on the line here. He needs to string together some points in a row if the Tigers are going to have a chance in this second set. No dice. That is Girard.
Again, we talked this afternoon about, you know, when teams are down, coming to the middle of the court, you know, gathering their thoughts together. The Tigers were doing that in the first set. They were doing it at the end of the match this afternoon, and again, they've gotten away from it. All they're doing is the point ends. They go back to where they're supposed to be in rotation. There's no communication. I know it's tough when you're down by this many, but like I've said in the past, that's when you need to pick each other up. And there you go. That's, you know, coming together, that's what you really need to see, encouraging each other.
Bremner back in here for Duquette. That was Etienne Gauthier who served that one in the net for Laval. And now Sander. Big booming serve. And Laval has the answer. Off of Travis McClain. And coach, we haven't really seen a team here this so far this year, even with Trinity Western, who are able to turn something into a positive so quickly. That was a big serve by Sander. And Laval just turned it around in a hurry.
Yeah, just then again, it came from a, you know, a good pass off a tough serve, and that seems to be the end of the second set. So,
wow, this has been an impressive display for the Rouge Or, and we are starting to see why they are the number one team in the country. This is a Dalhousie Tigers team that perennial AUS champions built for a run at a CIS championship on their home floor here at Dalplex, and the Rouge Or are making it look very easy so far.
Yeah, you know, and you'll hear a lot of volleyball coaches talk about how technical and how complicated this sport is. When you break it down to its very bone minimum, the object of the game is to put the ball on the floor on the other side of the net and keep it off your side of the net on the floor. And the Rouge Or are doing awfully good job of keeping the ball off their floor. So when, even when there's a tough serve or a big booming hit, they seem to be there whether to dig the ball or whether to pass the ball. And so there you go. We just, thanks, Aaron Montgomery, just got your message. We were talking about why they were maybe taking Travis out of the back row and passing, and that's to give Max Burt an opportunity to hit out of the back row. I hadn't considered that. Thanks for the feedback. With that said, I think when your team is struggling to pass and you have some other hitters on the team, you know, that strategy may or may not work. So thanks for that, Monty.
Thanks, Scott. Tigerswebcast at gmail.com is your email. And thanks to Eric for that email. And make sure you send us an email if you have any comments. We have our stats. And, coach, like the Sherbrooke game, not pretty. But for Laval, look at Frederic Debien, 14 kills.
Yeah, and I automatically looked down to the Tigers' stats just to see if I can figure something out. And, again, we talk about establishing the middle. You know, the ball's going to go to Max Burt, but you got to get your other middles established, whether it's Aaron Bernstock, Binstock, or Daniel Yu on the floor. Daniel Yu only has two attempts. He has one kill out of that. We haven't seen Aaron Bernstock. Binstock has same thing, two attempts, one kill. They really got to establish those guys in the middle as well. Yeah, you look at the three big hitters from Laval, Frederic Debien, 14 kills. Frederic Mondu, seven kills, two errors, 14 attempts. You know, so it's... you know, they're closer in stats than they were with Sherbrooke, which is a good sign, although it didn't show on the scoreboard in the second set.
Well, Coach, they're trying to get the participants to get going on this contest. We got to get back to our third set here. But I'm sure Dan Oda would be happy to have a few extra minutes to try to figure things out with this Tigers team. And
absolutely.
I remember from my days as a bad basketball coach, when things are going wrong, you just don't know what to do.
Like, that's right.
I'm sure maybe that Dan Oda's trying to figure out right now, obviously as one of the, not as a bad coach, but as one of the best coaches in the country. But how do you turn around this team right now? They are really struggling today.
I didn't think they struggled again in the first set. I thought they looked pretty good. You know, you talked about running over time, and the Laval coach, Pascal, has already kind of looked at the official and complained about the extra time here, which I think he might have a right to do. But anyways, looks like we're getting back to volleyball action here.
Well, sometimes when you're dealing with some rambunctious kids, mm-hmm. even trying to explain the rules of a basic sandwich game can take a little bit long.
That's right, yeah.
But they figured it out, and great times. Maybe the biggest rouse of applause so far at this Dowplex. It has been a struggle for this Tigers team. And our third and final interlock weekend of the season. The Tigers have really taken it on the chin from Quebec teams here today. But it is not done. They have another chance here, but not a good start. That is Girard getting back to work for Laval. Tigers team that has dropped out of the national rankings. And looking for answers here against the number one team in the country, Laval Rousseau. They will try to talk it out, but right away, the Laval is off to a two-set or a two-point lead. And it is Carl de Grandpre. Booming serve. Tigers scrambling, free ball for Laval. Boudreaux, and that one's going to sail. Ashley. Coach, it's off the Tigers in the front row. Is that a call or a touch call?
Yeah. I got to be honest, I didn't see a touch call there, but the officials are much closer than we are to the action, so.
Well, 3-0 for Laval. It's all going Laval's way now, both in performance and on the calls. The red and gold are looking good. Running Graham Higgins. And there we go. Higgins does well. They get that one to go.
Again, that off-speed shot seems to work for Higgins. They'll take a point now any way they can, I'm sure. So.
Now is your daughter watching?
No, she better be in bed, actually.
Well, this might be able to put her to sleep. If she
That's right, yeah.
If she's a Tigers fan.
She is a Tigers fan, yeah. Yeah, she knows Daddy used to coach there. And
was a Tiger, always a Tiger.
That's right, yeah.
Girard. 4-1 for Laval. That is out.
I must say on the women's side, though, she is an Acadia fan. She's two of the players on Acadia, Hillary Monette and Megan McDougall, have been coached by me for several years on the beach, and Joff Reboot, the head coach at Acadia. So anytime they're on the webcast, she always looks for Hillary and Megan. So.
I really like that Acadia team. I've done two of their games, both with the Tigers and with the Huskies, and they have a big kid in the middle who I can't remember what her name is. But a really long-arm kid who can really get up.
Well, they have Kristen, and Kristen, if you're listening, sorry for the pronouncement of your name if I get it wrong, but Budok.
Yes. Budok.
Budok. There you go, yeah. From Sudbury, I believe, which is where I went to university. It's Laurentian University, so.
She's a great player. She's really someone I think they can build around.
That's right, yeah. Meg Rector's also a good player. Again, they have a good core team. They're just... And the games they've lost this year have been so close, and you know you only see one win in the win column for them. But it's losses like 19-17 in a fifth set, or they're right there. They just can't seem to close for some reason. And I think Coach Reboot will turn that program around pretty quickly. They'll finish that strong, I think, the end of the season, and then look forward for next season. I think mathematically they still could be in the playoffs, but it's sort of a long shot now, sort of like the Ottawa Senators in the NHL.
Well, speaking of the women's volleyball side, with all those veterans, you got to think that St. Mary's team is going to be very hard to beat. Coming down the stretch, they have a lot of veteran talent. And wouldn't it be fun to talk about the men's conference in that way? You know, with all those teams. The women's conference has about 8 teams.
Yeah, it would be great.
And we talk about this all the time, and I just don't know why we can't get more men's volleyball teams in the conference. I'm an outsider. I'm a big volleyball outsider.
Yeah.
But I just don't know why we can't have more men's volleyball teams in the conference.
You know, a lot of it does go...
money.
It has to do with money, but it also has to do with the number of equality of men and women playing in the AUS, and schools want to make sure that there's an equal opportunity there for funding and for participation. So when you have bigger teams like football teams and hockey teams at some of the schools, that's why you don't see men's teams. So Acadia is a perfect example where they have both a football team and a hockey team. That's probably one of the reasons why you don't see a men's team.
Well, hopefully someday we will have a multi-team AUS men's conference. But for now, this is a dominant Tigers team in the AUS, really having their hands full with Laval, but Graham Higgins gets it a go. And now Higgins will go back to the service line. 7-3 for Dalhousie. Or for Laval, sorry, friends. Laval. And Le Rougeau are up 2 sets to none. That is Boudreau. And scrambling Tigers over by McLean. And a missed hit by Laval. And no problem for Ratza. So a rare mistake by Le Rougeau.
Yeah, well, good for the Tigers, too. We talked about the scrappy play of Laval in the first 2 sets, and Tigers are showing some of that now.
So the Tigers trying to rear back for some grit here. Bit of a mistimed hit there with Mondu. Ratsup right at the feet of Lapointe. And the fans are urging the Tigers now to make a run. 7-5 for Laval. And this is Higgins. And a response from Laval. And our first time out. And Olivier Bibeau-Pinard. With the head. So 8-5 for Laval here. In our early going, tigerswebcast@gmail.com. Is your email, tigerswebcast@gmail.com. And a Laval team that, again, it's so funny because with the teams that come here that we see in the U.S., we're used to Sander Ratsups and the big Kirkpatricks of UNB and these big boys. But now we've seen 2 Quebec teams again who are not necessarily tall, but as you said, they just are really athletic and can really get around.
That's right, and that scrappy thing about keeping the ball off the floor, that's... They will do anything to keep the ball off the floor, and I'm not suggesting at all that the Tigers aren't either, but again, that reputation from the Quebec League is, continues to be that way. So,
a Laval team about on the verge here of a 3-set sweep, 8-5 in this third set. Tigers back on the floor, looking for answers. And it is Mondu back to serve for Laval. That is Ratsup. A little bit confusion with Bremner. But now Ratsup's got it back. And that is off Laval.
He's got all the right angles.
You know, we talk about Ratsup's, you know, speed and power, and one of the things he has is vision. And when I talk about a hitter's vision is where to see the holes are, where the block is, and to be able to hit around it, over top of it, or sometimes just powering through it. And he has that ability. And to be a top player in the CIS, you need to have that.
Well, there was a big serve by Sander, but Laval gets it under control, and now the Tigers are scrambling. Sander from the back row, big hit, and a free ball for the Tigers from LaPointe. Look at Laval, just scramble and make it work. And that one goes long and point to the Tigers. So 8-7 for the Tiger, or for Laval. The Tigers now on a 4-1 run here. Trying to get back into this match. Dig Grand Prix. Sander again falls down. And Bremner. And that is off the Tigers, not a bounce. Well, Carl de Grand Prix, the fourth-year senior, 6'4", has been a beast. And 9-7 now for Laval. And Bebo Pinard. Aaron Binstock. And back to the service line, it's Binstock, 9-8. Running serve by Binstock. And crafty play there by Boudreau. A little dump by the center, and now he's back to serve for Laval. 10-8 for Le Rougeur. Sander Ratsup. Well, some moments of brilliance from Sander in this one.
Yeah, I think the Tigers are right back in here. If they can keep trading points, you know, they just need to, you know, get this one tied up, and we could be in for some more volleyball tonight than just a three-set game.
Big block by Higgins. Sounded like he took that one off the finger. And a hustling McLean keeps it in play. Wow. And Sander Ratsup saves it. But Laval in control here. And it is off the Tigers. And
yeah,
that one off the finger.
Yeah, you can see him holding it.
There's some crazy defense on the Tigers side.
So Bremner will shake that off. But that was a great hustle play by Dow. And even though they didn't get that point, that might get them going here.
Absolutely.
Service error for Dick Rompray.
That helps. Let's see if Bremner's affected by that ball off the finger here on the serve.
Well, this is Bremner. LaPointe. And what a big hit that was! What a big block by Max Burt. Finds the back corner.
Bremner serving.
Here's Bremner. LaPointe. And Mondu. Too much for the Tigers.
Yeah, they're trading back and forth, though. They're staying in this game. So as long as they can do that, give themselves a chance.
That's McLean, a tough pass off of Travis McLean. And that's going to be hard for the Tigers, and McLean can't get those ones under control.
He's the kind of kid that won't let that happen twice, though. I think they'll go back to him here, and it'll be a good pass.
Well, there's Travis.
Be wrong.
In system now. Ratsup. Laval makes it work. Confusion a bit, but to get it over. Graham Higgins. Too much for Boudreau.
Right
in our middle stages here of the third set, 13-12 for Laval. And on the service line, big Max Burke. Big serve from Max Lapointe. Well done. Debian blocked by Sander. And we're tied up.
You just feel in the building that the momentum's kind of swinging towards the Tiger side now. See it on the floor and hear it in the stands. It's
Max Bird will try to keep it going. Big serve, and Lapointe again does well. Into that. And an awkward hit for Mondu. Lapointe and Debian. Blocked again. Big show
wow.
Motion now. Rats up in good
yeah.
Stock.
One more time. One round of applause. How many people thought that was one of the blocks they've ever seen in their entire life?
And they're going to talk it over, Coach.
Yeah, so the question that Laval is asking is, Angus Rulin was in the back row. He went to set the ball, and the Laval player came over. Now, the call is if Angus Rulin tried to attack the ball and put it over the net, then he can't do that being in the back row. From where I'm sitting, and I'm not as close as they are. They're overturning the.
So it's to Laval.
It is to Laval. So yeah. The argument that the Tigers will be calling is that Rulin was trying to set the ball and the Laval player came over the net and impeded his set. So a call has to be made there, and it has to go either one of those calls. And unfortunately, it went against the Tigers there. So
take the point off the board for the Tigers. 14-12, I do believe, is the score. I said 14-13 for Laval. But back to the Tigers with Binstock. And we're tied up again, 14-14. Graham Higgins. Boudreau. And Mondu, great job by McLean to get to that. In the back row, Bremner. And now there's a big flying Debian. So Frederick Debian.
You know, give Laval credit. They're not, we spoke about the Tigers letting calls bug them. The coach seems to be sort of dealing with the calls, and the players are, getting set and ready for the next point. And, again, that's a sign of a champion, right? Big hit from Ratsup up there, though.
15-15, Sander Ratsup. And he will go back to the service line. So we're 1 point away from our second timeout. Boudreau. And getting it back under control is Dick Grandpre for Laval. Well, 16-15 here at the timeout, and at the very least, Coach, we're seeing some Tiger grit.
That's right. Yeah, it's they're not going to go away, especially when you're playing. If you can't get motivated to play the number one ranked team in the country, there's something wrong, and they are motivated here to win this third set anyways. They're staying in the game by sticking together, doing the things they need to do, talking. Again, it goes back to passing. They're passing a little bit better than they did in the second set. They've lessened the mistakes that they've made and the errors that they made that they did this afternoon. So.
Sure. Good times right there, Coach. That is Aaron Binstock's stat. Hello, Rob Binstock. Hello out there to Ethan and Jordan Binstock watching. Mr. Binstock in Halifax here to see the son Aaron play. And picked a rough day for the Tigers. But
so far, again, they can if they can win this set, who knows what can happen in the next set, and then we could be... going to a fifth game, which would be exciting for the fans here and at home.
So hello there to Ethan and Jordan Binstock. Your dad, Rob, is here and watching Aaron try to lead these Tigers to a comeback. And there we go. Bremner. 16-16. And here is Aaron Binstock, the fifth-year senior. Big hit. Well done by the Tigers to get this over. And a miss hit from the back row. And you can feel some momentum here starting to change. Now what's our call here, Coach?
I think they may be questioning the handset from maybe one of the Tigers. I'm not sure what the complaint is here.
Well, it's two of the Tigers. And here is the son of Rob Binstock, Aaron. Nice LaPointe, boot rope. Debier. Aaron Binstock gets it over. And the Tigers are scrambling. And a free ball here for Dow now. They can get in system. And it's Bremner. No mistake by Bremner. And hopefully not too little too late. The Tigers are starting to get their swagger on here.
Yep. You know, I mentioned how well Laval was doing with ignoring the calls that were going against them. And now they're letting that creep in a little bit too much. We have the Laval coach now yelling at the official.
What could be his beef over there on the far sidelines?
The last play, Angus Rulin went up and hit a ball. I think the argument was that the ball was still on their side of the net when he reached across. Or it could have been that he touched the part of the net that you're not allowed to touch now. Again, there are some parts of the net that you are allowed to touch, and it all depends what the play is and where it is on the net. So again, those could be the two arguments. Nevertheless, he's not very happy with Peter Moore this evening, but...
Well, it was great to see Rob Binstock, the father of Aaron, and for all you young volleyballers out there thinking about coming to Dow, I tell you what, trying to convince your parents to come spend a weekend in Halifax is never a hard thing to do. Every time the parents come here to see their kids play in Halifax, they always have a great time. It's a wonderful place to be, and good to see Rob Binstock here with supporting Aaron. Coach, you liked it so much, you moved from Ottawa.
That's right, yeah, 11 years ago.
18-18 now. We are back, so we have a big set here developing. The number one team in the country, Laval, against the perennial AUS champion, Dalhousie Tigers. Ratsup, that's off Laval to the Tigers.
Angus Rulin serving.
This is Angus Rulin. Confusion for Laval. They do well to get it over. But now a chance for the Tigers. From the back row, Ratsup. And that sailed on Sander. So missed opportunity for Dalhousie.
Yeah, again, they called a free ball for a reason. It should be a free point for the other team. So maybe a little overzealous there, but they can slide out here. They'll be okay.
The Grand Prix. And there you go. There's your side out, Burt, right in the midst of LaPointe. So 2019, and here is Calgary's Dan Bremner. LaPointe gets that one under control. Debier. Trebia. for Laval. Brian Duquette back in here for the Tigers. 20-20 in our third set. Laval leads 2-0. And miscommunication there with Ruland and Burt.
Yeah, I think Ruland tried to force that a little bit to Burt. He might have thought about going outside of Rats up there with a tight pass to the net.
21-20, your score for Laval here, trying to close in on a three-set sweep of the Dalhousie Tigers here at Dalplex. It's been not easy going for Laval, but, you know, a pretty country, but... You know, the Tigers now, we always forget how many championships they've won in a row. I think we're up to 26.
Yeah, I don't know the exact.
As we talked about with the Sherbrooke game today, Tigers fans aren't used to seeing us here at Dalplex. The Tigers are in trouble of being swept for the day.
Yes.
3-0, they lost to Sherbrooke. Down 2-0 to Laval and down 21-20. There is Sander. It's played by Laval. Damien. Travis McLean gets it over, but a chance for Laval.
So again, to get that extra help on defense in the back row and passing, and every time he's done that, it's seemed to pay off for him. That is impressive.
And now the Tigers are starting to feel it here in the third set.
Bird had serving at the beginning of the match. I think that rust is gone. That was an impressive serve. I mean, they weren't around that at all, and I would have liked to have had a radar gun to see how fast that that serve was. His hand, and then it was already on the floor on the other side of the net, and nobody on Laval moved. So.
Serve by Max Burt has got the Tigers up a point here, 22-21. The Tigers are trying to push this to a fourth set. Showing some Tiger grit here in the third. And a big crowd at Dalplex trying to get the Tigers going. This is Max Burt. Comes up well short on that one. That's Max.
Yeah, they just need to side out right away and get the ball back. And again, going with that two-person serve receive seems to work well for them. Lots of space for them to talk and move. There we go.
Sander Ratsup. Off the hands of LaPointe. And we got Angus Campbell coming in with some height.
Yeah, that's right. They bring him in to do that duty on blocking, and we'll see if Laval goes after him.
So it is Dan Brunner, or Graham Higgins, sorry, Graham Higgins to serve. The Grand Prix. Rulin. And out from Debian. And the Tigers are 1 point away from a set victory.
Tigers, make some noise.
the fans really want it here. This is Higgins. And that is it by Mondu. Angus Ruland. So point of the match here, Mondu can either put us to extra points or give the Tigers their first set victory.
Yeah, and watch here. They've as Eric Montgomery has showed us, they have taken Travis McLean out of the passing reception to use Max Burt as a back row attack. Let's see if they use him here.
Ruland and Sander, and blocked by Laval. And we will go to extra points, 24-24.
We're all tied up at 24 apiece.
So the number one team in the country, Laval, has an answer for this Tigers push. That one does get over, and a meeting of the minds there at the net. And it goes to Dalhousie.
That was all heart.
After every practice. 25-24 for the Tigers. So the Tigers have the hammer. And it's Ratsup. There's Sander. Nice job by Lapointe. Boudreau. And wow! Good Grand Prix.
Laval not backing down.
25-25 now. And Etienne Gauthier now to serve. He will come in to serve. This is Gauthier. Higgins. Ruland. Sander. Nicely done. That nearly hit the
spot. Oh.
Change of pace for Laval. And Bremner!
Thought maybe there should have been a hand call on Laval center there. Tight call. You know, it's a tough position for the officiator to make a call like that at 25 all, but we're back to game point for the Tigers.
Well, the Laval coach, Pascal Clement, was not happy with that point by his Rouge Or. There's a block! And Laval's got it under control. De Grand Prix. Hustling Angus Ruland. Bremner. And on the far side again, and De Grand Prix. He has been a force. 26-26. And now here is the setter, Boudreau. He has played throughout. Travis McLean. Angus Ruland. And Bremner. All right, Dan Bremner. And now the Tigers with another chance.
This is fun to watch.
Set point number four for the Tigers. Debian. Well done by Ratson. Dan Bremner. That is to Laval. Tigers have had four set points here. But Laval keeps holding him off. And now De Grand Prix. What a play by Travis McLean. Big block there and out to the Tigers. So, coach, at some point, Tigers got to cash in here. This is their fifth set point.
Yeah, I'd like to see them have a little bit of a tougher serve. Make it, you know, make Laval move, you know, where they seem to be serving right at them.
Oh, there we go, you know, again, Lapointe. Yep. Boudreau. And McLean to Laval. So, exactly, coach. That was right to Lapointe and no problem.
You know, and serving to Libero, and I don't know the reputation of this Libero, but he's played, in my mind, an okay game. But
28-28. And Michael Girard. Bremner gets it started with Ruland. Max Burke. The sixth set point for Dalhousie. And here we go, Coach. I mean, this may be the answer. Max Burke. If he can come up with a big booming serve here. There it is. Off the net, though. Got a piece. And that's
there it
wide.
Is.
And the Tigers have their first set of the day. The heart of a champion, if you will. Not to sound too cliche, but some Tiger grit.
That's right. You know, they didn't give up. I think they were down, 7-3 at one point in this match. And, you know, they never gave up. They had the momentum going into the third set. They have to come out strong. They have to come out ready. Laval will be fired up. They don't like to lose, obviously, being ranked number one. This could be a very fun four set.
Well, that's the swagger we're used to from Dalhousie. You know,
that's right.
We always talk about how hard it is for UNB and Munn to come in here and play these Tigers. They just are always so confident. And we've seen them throughout the day look kind of rattled at times. But in that set, as it went on, that's the Tigers team we're used to seeing, just a natural confidence.
That's right. It's that almost that puffy chest thing. They walk around with their, you know, their chest heaved and ready to play. And you know, there's a, it just seems like there's a lot more fight in them tonight than there was this afternoon. So.
Two sets to one for Laval.
You know, the big hitters for Dal, you know, showed up in that third set. Max Berg getting 10 kills. Sander Epsuk getting 11. Max Berg with that big service ace that we saw towards the end of the match. And again, the ball's being spread a little bit better this evening than it was this afternoon. Again, I'd still like to see, you know, Binstock get the ball a little more. You know, as a veteran on the team, every time the ball had gone to him, it seemed in the third set, it only went to him, it says seven times here. I think that's generous. I didn't think I saw that many. But, you know, he got three kills out of those seven, and he only made one error. So, you know, look for them to go to him. Looking on the other side at Laval, again, the story for them is Debier. 17 kills, only two errors, 40 attempts. Mondu showing up big time too. 10 kills, 4 errors. You know, and you look at the digs on both sides. When we looked at the digs this afternoon, I think it was 33 and 34 after three sets. We're now looking at 45 for Laval and 40 for Dal. And that's what makes this match so much fun, is the big booming hits, but then that outstanding digs on both sides happening for both teams. So
there's been a lot of hits where as soon as it leaves the hand, the hit, you think, okay, that's it. Like, there's no way. But the other team has an answer.
Yeah, somehow they managed to get it up. And, you know, again, there's a lot of technique involved. And I know a lot of coaches out there, and I'm one of them, that will say defense is 90% mental, 10% technical. You got to be there, want the ball, be relaxed, dig it up. You know, we talked about this afternoon how the Tigers seemed tight on defense. You know, things were coming off their forearms and hitting the ceiling, or they were flying out into the stands, and now they're just relaxed. The arms are bent. The ball keeps in play. It's a more determined Tigers team than we saw this afternoon, for sure.
And we are back to it. And the Tigers are on the left-hand side of your screen, and Le Rougeur are on the right. TigersWebcast@gmail.com is your email. And Laval leads 2-1. Coach Damian Stapleton. My name is Bill McLean. Our cameraman is Pardeep. And Jonathan is our producer. And we've had a lot of fun here tonight, but hopefully the Tigers can maybe push this to a fifth set. That is Higgins, and Bremner gets it through the block. And Big Ron Bray, that one sails on him.
I think it's important that the Tigers got that first point. You know, having the momentum coming out of the third set there, and then starting off with a point, I think will help them here.
So here's Brenner, Tigers leading 1-0. And a response from Laval with Mundu.
Laval heads in right back.
And here is Justin Boudreau. Ratsip, Rulin. Bit of a missed time there, but just enough for Max Burt.
Yeah, again, when you play the amount of volleyball at a high level that Max has, you know, when you miss time something, you know, you have the ability and the athleticism to make something work when it doesn't look like it can.
This is Max back to serve. Well done by Lapointe into that vicious serve and a block by Higgins. Debian. And that's off the ceiling from Max Burt. Frederick Debian with a big kill. Dig Ron Prey back to serve. McLean. Bremner blocked by Mondu and Girard.
Again, Dal has a great pass there. I'd love to see them get Binstock going. You know, again, the ball hasn't gone to him very much this game. I know there's other Binstocks out there that would like to see him get the ball too.
Looks like the alcohol is finally kicking in.
3-3. Now Graham Higgins. He was a stud in today's match against Sherbrooke. And a miss hit by Laval. And an easy point for the Tigers.
With the changeup. Boy, Tigers, Higgins to serve again.
So 4-3 for Dalhousie. Little change up. Mondu, very good, off of Ruland.
Binstock a little upset with himself. He went up with the setter and knew that he'd made a mistake when the ball went outside. And
nearly hits the ceiling. Brought down for Ratsa. In the back row. Big block by the Tigers.
Equal one, Florida, Boy, Tigers. Center rats that back to serve.
5-4 now for Dalhousie. This is Sander. Wow. Big serve. Back to troll by Laval. And now the Tigers are scrambling. Rulin. Bremner. Very nice.
That is a great spot on a tough, tough set.
Sander Ratsap serving.
6-4 for the Tigers. Lapointe gets to that one. And Laval.
Again, you can hear the Dal coaching staff, you know, wait is what you can hear. You really need to have patience on the block.
So Debian to the service line, 6-5 for the Tigers. Wow, flying Sander Ratsup, and a big show of emotion from Sander.
Again, the hustle by Rulin makes that play possible.
For the Tigers. Binstock just got enough. Mondu. Sails on Mondu. And our first timeout. So a response from the Tigers. Down 2-0, win the third set, and now 8-5 here as our first timeout.
That's right. As I said off the top, it was important for them to get that first point, you know, to show them that they still have the momentum going in to this fourth and really important set. I like to see them taking risks on their serves. You know, a lot of their serves are just touching the top of the tape and whatever. That makes the other team have to move, which we talked about. You know, I said they got to serve a little tougher or whatever. And when I was working with Geoff Reboot at Acadia, and he loves when I call him Reboot, by the way, so that's why I'm announcing it that way. He does a drill where, you know, it's touch the top of the tape, touch the top of the tape, you know. And because when you see a loop over the net, the other team has lots of time to get settled and move their feet. Where, you know, if the trajectory of the ball is coming sort of flat, it's a much harder serve to pass. So
eight to five for the Tigers. And Aaron Binstock. Love point. And that is off of Binstock. So side out to the Rouge Or.
It'll be important here for the Tigers to just play their game. They settle into this game. You don't have to play outside of your game or try to do too much more than what you can do, and they'll be fine here.
Max Bird got just enough. And for the back row, Debian. And well, does very well. And 8-7 the score. I thought it was 8-8, but 8-7 for the Tigers. Ruling. Flying Graham Higgins. Change of pace. Great adjustment there from Higgins.
Yeah, you can see Rulin give him the kind of thumbs up, the kind of thanks for bailing me out there. It wasn't the right height for that set, but anyways, he made it work.
9-7. There's your response from Laval. 9-8 now. And again, it's Debian. He has been a beast. And Bibo Pignard. Roulin and Max Burks. Got just enough to make that work. That 10-8 for Dalhousie. Bremner again. Degron Prey. He got all of that. Hits the official from Travis McLean. So Debian and De Grand Bre have really been a force for Laval. And now Sander trying to respond, and a block by Laval. And now Laval is starting to get their swagger back. 10-10. Service error.
Tigers, Max Burt.
11-10 for Dazzy. And here is Gander Newfoundland's Max Burt. Nicely done by Lapointe. Debian blocked by Binstock. And a big show of emotion from Binstock.
That's a big-time block and a big point in the match.
12-10 for Dalhousie. Merckx just barely got over. Easy pickings for Aaron Binstock. And we got a timeout by Laval, and not bad when you're playing the number one team in the country. You got a couple fifth-year seniors, Burt and Bidstock, now really combined here for the Tigers.
Yeah, that's what you expect out of your veterans, to lead the team. Again, whether it's, you know, by the show of emotion or just leading by example, you know, getting it done when it needs to get done. You know, a lot of times when there's an overpass or an overbump by the other team and you go up to hit it, you get so excited and the adrenaline's pumping that a lot of times you end up hitting it out the back of the court or into the net. So it looks like an easy play, but sometimes it can be tricky. So you have to make sure you put it away, and Binstock made sure of that this time.
So we're approaching about 2 hours here in this match. And it's 2 sets to 1 for Laval. And 13-10 in the fourth set for the Tigers. Trying to push it to a fifth set, and they got one of their veterans, Max Burt, on the service line. Max did not play today against Sherbrooke. Still working his way back from the injury. LaPointe again. Boudreau and Debier. And now the Tigers, nicely done there by Binstock. And a big play by Laval, but miss hit. And the Tigers with some separation now. 14-10 for Dalhousie. This is Burt. And that one, a service error on Max Burt. There is Carl Digrenfre. Travis McLean, Angus Rulin, and Sander. Vicious. Officials gonna have words here for the captains.
Yeah, I think there's been some talk through the net, and yeah, he's just gonna put a stop to that pretty quick. Emotions are already high in a game like this. You don't need the business of going through the net and the looks through the net and some of that. But again, as young men, you get fired up, and you know it's happening on both sides, and sometimes it's a fun part of the game to watch too. But there's a line, and Peter Moore is making sure that they're not gonna cross that line. So.
Well, Laval response, 15-12 for the Tigers. Michel Girard, the server, Laval. That is going to go out, so good call by the Tigers. And our second time out, 16-12 for the Tigers.
You know, the Tigers can't let up here. They have to come back out of this timeout, be ready for every point. One of the things we talked about last year when they were heading into the CIS Championships, we did a webcast just before. It might have been the playoffs, I'm not sure, but they were playing UMB, and one of the things that was happening during that match was their inability to finish and close the match. I think they were up, you know, 21-14, and they let UMB come back, and I mean, ultimately they won, and you would ask me at that point, what do they need to do when they get to the CIS Championships? What do they need to work on? And it's that closing of a match that they needed to work on. And we saw that. They were up in some of the matches when they got out west and weren't able to finish. So the big message from Coach Oda here, he'll remind them of their strategies of what they're supposed to do, take care of what they need to take care of, watch your emotions through the net, and let's finish this game.
Well, the Tigers have battled back, down 2 sets to none, won the third, and now lead the fourth set 16-12. And the Laval Rougeor, the number one team in the country. So a nice show of force here by Dalhousie. Ruland. Bremner. Now LaPointe. Debian. And that would have gone out, but Higgins plays it. And it goes off the ceiling.
The change of scorers for LaValle. Trying to beat Debian back to serve.
So a bit of a miscue here by Graham Higgins. Ruland. Bremner. Debian. Off the face of Ratsup. Changed the pace there off the net.
Yeah, and it took Ratsup up a little bit. He was expecting a big hit, and he came off the net, and he got his feet crossed. But Tigers just need to settle down here and side out.
16-14 for Dalhousie. LaValle trying to make a push. That is Sander. Change of pace. Well done, Sander Ratsup.
Shot scores.
17-14.
You'll see lots of shots like that at the World Championships. You know, that's. I think the beach game's really added to the indoor game with the different roll shots and different paces of shots. It's fun to watch.
Hustling Tigers, and they clear over there. But no luck for Dalhousie.
Tigers are hustling, going for every ball.
Well, here's LaValle trying to get back into this, trailing 15-17, up 2-1. They do not want this to go to a fifth set. Ruland, Bremner, LaPointe. And what a great hit by Doug Grandpre.
Again, it all started with that great dig in the backcourt. I mean, that, again, like you said, you see the ball come off the hand, you think, oh, that's a point, and then all of a sudden, some way, somehow, the ball's up in the air.
LaValle on a 4-1 run here. Ruland and Sander from the back row. Debian gets to it. And now De Grandpre hits the net. And 18-16 for the Tigers. So LaValle was set up there pretty nicely by De Grandpre with a miss hit. And now the Tigers with a chance here. In system is LaValle from the back row, and too much for Ruland. Angry with himself, but he should have had it.
Ball off the defender and out. Point LaValle.
18-17 for the Tigers.
Etienne Gauthier.
And it's going to be Etienne Gauthier.
Bibo Pinal. Etienne Gauthier will serve.
So here is Gauthier. Sander, Angus Ruland, and Big Max Burt gets it past Gauthier.
Almost three to his head on the down point.
19-17.
Bremner serving.
Here is Bremner. De Grandpre with the answer.
Substitution and back into the match.
And here's our libero substitution coach.
Yeah, again, they've seen so much success with this. You have the two best passers on the team pass right now. They're leaving them all alone, the two of them to pass. Almost like you would see on the beach.
McLean. Wow, Max Burt gets blocked. And now Sander gets blocked.
Oh, wow.
Play.
I think he did that with his left hand.
With the left hand for Sander. A little bit of wherewithal. 2018 for the Tigers. Here is Max. LaPointe. And to LaValle. Net violation.
Hit the calls there. The setter went to play the ball, and apparently one of the Tigers touched it while he was trying to set it. So it's It's called an over-the-net violation. You have to let the setter try to set the ball. And
so a break for Laval. Sander wraps up. 21-19.
Looks like they're bringing Angus Campbell in again for Angus Rulin to get that block. So
and this is Graham Higgins on the service line. 21-19 for Dalhousie. LaPointe. Rulin in system. Chris Girard. 21-20.
Substitution back of the match for the Tigers. Angus Rulin replacing Angus Campbell.
Rulin back in here.
Also, substitution on the Laval side. Back to the match. Olivier Bibo
and Bibo in here for Laval. Some size up front. Rulin. Sander rats up, and there's Pignon.
It's going to be tight.
And a tough set there. Sander tried the left-hander again. Didn't work.
Yep. You know, 4 or 5 points ago, I said, you know, play within your means. You don't need to play. You don't need to try to do things that you can't do. And, I mean, he was successful on that one. But that ball was a lot tougher than the last one he did. So.
21-21. Sander again. That time, no mistake. And Dan Bremner back in.
You know, what makes championship teams, whether we're talking about the number one team in the CIS or the AUS right now, we talk about the big men and the top players, but there are those role players that come in and they do their job, whether it's a serving specialist or, you know, Duquette came in and played three rotations in the back row and did his job.
Binstock and Bremner doing a job there. 23-21 for the Tigers. And the Tigers 2 points away from pushing this to a fifth set. And it just seemed like an hour ago, the Tigers seemed absolutely dead in the water, but we have a big response.
That's right, and I think it was maybe 40 minutes ago that I just said you could feel it in the building. The tide was changing. I said you could see it on the floor, and you could hear it in the cheering in the crowd. And, you know, this game's not over. You know, Laval side outs here. They're only 1 point down. So this is a big point. Tigers get this. They're at game point, and they just need to either get the next point or side out. So.
Well, Coach, it's been a Tigers team that, again, you know, throughout the what we've seen from them so far, they just haven't seemed to get going. You got to think a victory over the number one team in the country could be that turning point.
Yeah, and I think the turning point may have happened last night when Max Burt returned. Again, we didn't see him play this afternoon. He's obviously been a factor in this game.
Sander rats up. Oh. And a tough time for a service error from Sander. But that is the case. And Frederic Debian.
It's a good pass here. I'd like to see the ball. Again, I've said it many times. I'd like to see the ball go to a veteran like Binstock here, who you know he's just, you know, he's going to do what he can to put it away. Not that the other players won't, but...
Frigo with the serve. And Bremner. Debian. That was Mondu and hustling Tigers now. And a chance for Laval. Mondu again. Blocked by Binstock. And confusion, but now finds Bremner. And off Laval. For the Tigers. And we are going to have a substitution here for Binstock. Kenneth Ruerta. Here comes the big left-hander. This is Roberta. And not what Dan Oda had in mind.
Just a little short Tigers look in. With a golden side out. Back to serve.
24-23 for the Tigers.
Just need to side out here. Again, need a good pass.
This is Mondu.
Yeah, big Max on the front there.
Well, there's Max. And a chance for Laval. And there's Laval. So once again, we'll go to extras. Big Grand Prix. Well, Coach, they got it. You called it. They had Max Burt. But a big block by Laval.
Yep, I think look for him again or Ratsup out of the back row.
It's Ratsup from the back row and it sails. So the Tigers are getting the shots they want but can't finish. And Laval has match point. So frustrating, Coach. You called it both times. They got the shots they wanted, but both times they just could not get it finished.
Yeah, I give Laval credit. They, you know, they keyed on Max Burt in the on that first point. Were able to block him and won that rally. And then just a hitting error from Ratsup. Thought the set was a little low from Rulin, but nevertheless it sailed out the back. And they're looking at, like you said, game point here. So.
It is match point for Les Rouges et Or. Do the Tigers have one more push left in them? They have battled back. And now trail 2 sets to 1. Facing match point. And it's Frederick Mondu for Laval. Rulin. Sander Ratsup does not hit the ceiling. Comes back down. Rulin and Bremner. The point gets to it. De Grand Prix. And it's over. Laval. De Grand Prix with the exclamation point. And a 3-set-to-1 victory for Laval. They survive a gritty comeback from the Tigers.
Laval takes this match.
So 3-1 for Laval. No doubt now they will keep that number one ranking in the country. The Tigers will drop to 8-5 on the season.
Round of applause.
But led by usual suspects, Sander Ratsup, Max Burt, Graham Higgins, Aaron Minstock, the Tigers made a run, but just came up short.
Yeah, and that's a tough loss. I thought they were in control. We were looking at 23-21. I thought they were looking pretty, but again, you're number one ranked for a reason when you're in the country, and you know they have a really good coaching staff on Laval with Gino Brusso and Pascal there. So that's a tough loss, but we saw promising things from the Tigers that we didn't see this afternoon. So,
Coach, I thought Pierre Lapointe, the libero for Laval, really got a lot of great first passes here for the Laval Rouge Or tonight.
Yeah, I thought his passes were pretty good. The Tigers made an adjustment, stopped serving to him because he was doing so well. But the digs he was making were just phenomenal. And, again, it's a cliche, but defense wins championships, right? So, anyways...
It was a battle of Dedez, Frederic Debien, and Carl De Grand Prix, the outside hitters for Laval. They brought a lot of force to the table.
Absolutely, yeah. You know, one of the things that the Tigers can take away from that is, you know, that it was 3-1. They win this set. Who knows who wins the fifth set? The good news is that the Tigers are not too far away from this number one ranked team.
Yeah.
You know, when you lose the scores that they did, and, you know, the second set was a little shaky with the score being, was it 25-13 or something. You know, that was a bit of a miscue, but to see how close they kept it in the other three sets is, that's a really promising thing for Dal, and you know, Oda won't be happy. Coach Oda won't be happy about losing that fourth set. But I think he'll take away, you know, from this game, I guess what I'm taking from it, and hopefully the rest of the Tigers can too.
Well, after seeing the Tigers kind of not mail it in, but maybe not scrap like they might have usually against today, this afternoon against Sherbrooke, you can only think that watching the way Laval just never gave up on a point, you got to think that's going to be a building block for the Tigers, you know, to learn that, or not to learn, but, you know, to see a team just the way that Laval was able to turn negatives into positives, it's going to be good for the Tigers.
Yeah, for sure it is. And, you know, we talked a lot about, you know, them not being ranked top 10 in the country, whatever rankings are, what they are. They're voted on by the coaches, you know, throughout the CIS. And, even when they were ranked, Coach Oda never, ever, you know, brought that up. You know, we have to be top 10 in the country. That's not his focus. His focus is we need to win the AUS championship first and foremost to get ourselves in the CIS championship. Obviously, he wants to put himself in a better situation. You know, top five, top six, you're going to not have to play that first team that's ranked. But, you know, this, as I said, could be a preview of the first game of the CIS championships if the Tigers can win, what are we saying, the 27th consecutive AUS championship. So.
Coach Damian Patterson, my friend, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Outstanding stuff all day long. And remember, your email is tigerswebcast@gmail.com if you have any comments about the broadcast today. The next time we'll be on the air is tomorrow at 3 o'clock for women's volleyball. It's the Tigers versus the UDM and Legley Blue, Moncton Legley Blue. That will be a good one, so make sure you tune in. That Tigers and Legley Blue tomorrow at 3 o'clock Atlantic. Thanks to Jonathan, our producer, Pardeep, our cameraman, Damian Patterson, the coach, and myself, Bill McLean. Hope you enjoy the broadcast. The final score from the Dalplex, Laval Rouge or 3 and the Tigers 1. Have yourselves a wonderful evening.